Hello students, welcome to the series on marketing management. Today we are going to study introduction to marketing. In this we will basically cover the concept of marketing, the definition of marketing and the functions of marketing. We are also going to study the channels of basic marketing in terms of distribution and the importance of consumer. Now when we talk about marketing, it is basically a broad area which covers most of the activities related to the sale of the product. Marketing is important because we genuinely want to run businesses, we genuinely want to grow the businesses. According to Patricia, you don't close a sale, you open a relationship if you want to build a long-term successful enterprise. So whenever you get a customer or a client, you basically need to build a kind of a relationship. This relationship has to sustain in order to crystallize sales. Any business organization, whether it is a retail sector or a manufacturing sector, needs the support and the basic impact of marketing in order to enhance the sales. According to Robert Lewis, everyone lives by selling something. So selling is the basis of the survival of human life itself. Every person who earns money gives something to the other. According to Bo Bennett, affiliate marketing has made businesses millions and ordinary people millionaires. So marketing is basically a function which creates wealth into the market. It genuinely enhances the profits and the profitability of the organization because it tries to portray the goods and tries to increase the awareness in terms of the consumers where goods are sold to the customers. According to Lisa, the secret is to make the time to immerse yourself in the people you are marketing to live them, breathe with them and study them from every angle. So customer is that important. You have to live with them, you have to grow with them, understand their needs and the passions and the desires and supply what they need. Marketing is important because basically it relates to the kind of the growth and the development of the product. According to Millen, business has only two functions, that is marketing and innovation. Innovation is the basic creativity in terms to design the products and give values to the customers. The new developments, the changing trends and the kind of the fashions and the standards of living in the society are increased by the innovations taking into the market and in the business concept. The market portrays the goods in a new way and tries to crystallize the concepts based on the needs and the desires of the people. Customers are important. You have rich customers, you have mediocre customers, but we have to focus on customers who generate sales to us or who are rich people associated with us, who generate profits to the organization. They are the basis for the sustained growth of the organization. So according to Seth Godin, your best customers are worth far more than your average customers. You need special focus, you need special attention and special selling promotions in order to satisfy these customers. Genuinely, a kind of a concept which impacts marketing is built on something that is wonderful and something that is beautiful. It tries to design the things in a creative way. It gives the beauties and the extensions to the values associated with the product functions. According to Bill Gates, who is the richest man, he says, being the richest man in the cemetery doesn't matter to me. Going to bed at night saying we have done something wonderful that matters me most is important. So this basically says to design and to give something to society is the function of marketing. The kind of the development, the kind of the standards of living, the kind of the norms and the practices of standardized practices taken into the market have been the basic gifts of marketing. Marketing has bestowed human life with the riches and with the flamboyant products which display the status and the kind of the glamour associated with the human life. Now this was all about the importance of marketing in terms where we take the introductory aspect to study how marketing impacts lives and businesses. Now let's study the technical aspect of marketing where we will cover few standard definitions. Now the marketing definition according to the Chartered Institute of Marketing says the management process responsible for identifying, anticipating and satisfying customer requirements is probably marketing. According to Philip Kotler, satisfying needs and wants through an exchange process is marketing. According to learnmarketing.net, it says, marketing is not about providing the product or services. It is essentially about the changing needs and the demands of the customers. But the common sense of all these and the common aspect of all these definitions is we have to meet the needs of the customers and provide benefits to the customers. Now, before marketing, we have to study what is a market because marketing is carried out in a concept what is known as market. According to Philip Kotler, A market consists of all the potential customers sharing a particular need or want, who might be willing and able to engage and exchange to satisfy that particular need and want. So this is basic marketing in terms simple definition. The American Marketing Association says marketing is the process of planning and executing the conception, pricing, promotion and distribution of ideas, goods and services to create exchanges that satisfy the individual and the organizational goals. The Chartered Institute of Marketing again says marketing is the management process responsible for identifying, anticipating and satisfying customer requirements profitability. The recent definitions which have evolved and given a kind of a basic shape to marketing is shown over here. The updated definition in 2004 again by IMA is given over here. Marketing is an organizational function and a set of process for creating, communicating and delivering value to the customers and for managing customer relationship in ways that benefits the organization and its stakeholders. Now, the role of marketing in the society is immense. It not only tries to impact the business, but it impacts the life and the standards of living. The life process in terms of the standards displayed, the practices taken into the market, the way business is performed, the kind of the sharing of the knowledge and the trends shaping the human society are all the impacts of marketing. Now, marketing involves the investment of the organizational resources where we have to have an effective match in terms to the specification needs of the target market, where we have to design some strategies and some kind of behavior which genuinely is based on the kind of the attainment of the organizational goals and objectives. And by the combination of all these, we get the customer satisfaction. So marketing is talking about customer satisfaction, that is the basis and the survival of the business. Customer satisfaction is the most essential function of marketing, which genuinely needs a kind of an extra focus. The marketing concept has key issues. The basic purpose is to create a customer and to live with the customer. We need to have a customer because customer is the king of the business. So the importance of customer can be understood by this basic line, that how important it is to keep customers, because if you don't have customers, generally the businesses are going to close. Customer is important because he survives in the market. So what is a market? According to Kotler in 2004, a market consists of all the potential customers sharing a particular need or who might be willing and be able to engage and exchange to satisfy the need or want. So market is that important because here the customers are living and here the customers do share the concepts related to sharing of information and goods. Now we have various types of markets in terms of the consumer markets. We have the industrial and the business markets. We have the reseller markets in terms of the retailers and the distributor markets. We have the public markets in terms of the government, the agencies, the departments and the institutions buying goods and services. We have the international and global markets where we have standardized goods and products sold. So various markets have different kinds of customers and the different customers need different goods and services according to the needs and the requirements. The price ratio also differs in terms where the impact has to be carried. Marketing is also in relation where we have the micro marketing aspects and we have the macro marketing aspects. Now, when we talk about the micro marketing aspect, it relates to the marketing of a company. But when we talk about the macro marketing, it relates to the whole economy. So the company resides into the nation and nation is a kind of an economy. So the economy also has to sustain in order to stand in the global standards where a brand name of the country becomes also important. Now when we talk about these concepts, let's see what is micro marketing. Micro marketing for a company thinks you need to accomplish the organizational goals and objectives. But at the macro level, we need that the whole economy has to grow. So the whole economy and its flow of goods and services from producers to consumers in order to earn profits and growth is important, and this basically enhances the concept of the macroeconomic aspects. Micro marketing is not just selling stuff, but it is also looking at what the customers want and how do we enhance the satisfaction. And at the macro level, we have to look into the factors at the international, at the national level. Looking at how everybody in the country can have access to the things that they need. The governments have to be responsible in order to give those particular needs and satisfaction and have a kind of a fair system where the consumers can use these products. When we talk about the macro marketing, it is associated with the social concept because the society becomes important. And here the social norms and the social justice and the ethics put a very big impact on the social marketing. Now, the definition of social marketing basically relates to this aspect. It is defined as the design and the implementation and control of the programs aimed at increasing the acceptability of the social idea or a practice in one or more group of the target adopters. So, generally we have to build a concept which revolves around the social practices, where we have to be fair in businesses. Being fair in businesses is to give the products and services of quality standards, or it is the customer must get the full return for whatever the value of the money he has invested. And this return and exchange of process in terms of fair values would sustain market and would sustain society. Now, the social marketing approach has basically 7 components related to knowledge, desire, skills, optimism. It is facilitation, stimulation, and reinforcement. When we talk about knowledge, it is to build up ideas and to share the kind of the information related to the religion, the traditions, and the product itself. The desire is the need and the want of the customer. The skills is your competency and ability to serve into the market. Optimism is to genuinely give the positive aspects to the customer or to provide positive services and positive goods which can generate value to the society. There has to be a concept where we have to differentiate what alcohol can do in the society and what education can do to the society. So, we have to weigh the balance in terms what the society will benefit, and if the provider of the services is related to the better half or the better provider in terms of the educational values related to the enhancement of the growth of the society, he will be more accepted into the market, and that basically leads to the economic growth of the society. When we talk about facilitation, it is to provide a kind of a connectivity in terms of infrastructure, where we need to build up hospitals, schools, roads, railways, everything to facilitate human life. Stimulation is to provide a kind of a stimulus in terms of advertising and generate a desire and to make people aware that how these facilities are important, how education is important and how health is important, or how money is important through the banking services. Reinforcement is to build a kind of a positive impact in terms of feedback, where the customers should feel good that they have these services, and the accessibility to these services will enhance their growth in life. So, when we talk about the marketing, it also consists of a concept related to brand. The brand has basic enhancement in terms where you try to increase the association of the product to the consumers and then give a basic pride to the customers in terms of using that product. And the customer relates himself to the organization in terms of the brand he uses. The brand has a kind of awareness and concept where the percentage of the respondents having heard of a designated brand, that is aided or unaided way of hearing, basically reinforces the concept of brand awareness. Brand awareness is carried into the market not only by advertising, but it is also by the integrity of your actions. It is the integrity of the character, and it is the integrity of the quality of services which you give to the market, builds up the kind of the positive faith of the customers in your minds. The attitudes towards the brand intensity is important in terms. This is the number of respondents and the intensity of feeling positive or negative towards a specific brand. We have already discussed what are positive products, how these products would enhance the ability in order to enhance the quality of human life. The quality of human life has to be enhanced in terms of the valuable services we give in order to generate growth. A growth which is genuinely a kind of aware and a kind of empowered customer who has the basic ability to genuinely define what is good for him. Then we have the intentions to purchase. The intentions is the number of people who are planning to buy a particular specified product or an object within the designated time period. So, we have to decide and see what are the buying behaviors or what is the consumer behavior and what are the basic desires and motivation. And on the basis of the importance of these factors, we are going to calculate what has to be highlighted and what could become the unique selling proposition of the product. The importance of factors basically relates the intensity of the influence of each factors in order to crystallize a utility. The markets are classified on the basis of the demographic characteristics, where the brands have to relate to each group. The brand has to speak to the demographic details of the market. The demographic details talk about the age, gender, occupation, status, income level, and so forth of the individuals providing the information. So, these are the micro level segmentations of the market, where the brand has to communicate to each segment according to the relevance and It has to satisfy the desires and the kind of the basic perceptions required and needed by each group. Now, when we talk about branding, it becomes important because it relates to the customer's perceptions. According to Kapferer, branding is not based on what goes on with the brand, but rather what goes in. It should be an investigation of the brand's very substance, the facets of brand identity. So, it is important that the concept of brand basically relates to the identity and the impact it carries in the minds of the customers. Businesses need to focus on the vision, the values, and the immediate corporate values. We need to have the long-term goals in order to crystallize the benefits given to the customers. The customers need to be related to the company in order to have a kind of a loyalty and an impact in terms to increase the kind of relationship with the company. Brands become important because brands relate to a personality. Identity is important into the market. Personality basically relates to the human qualities and the abstract values associated with the persona of the brand. It is the product which gives the benefits in terms what the customers want, not only in terms of the physical satisfaction in a way where utilities become important, but it is the abstract association with the product where the status and the goal of a person to achieve and to carry a particular product becomes a kind of a status symbol in the society. It is a want to increase the likelihood that the customer would relate to the brand and want to be a part of it, because a successful brand basically makes the customer successful. It speaks about his achievements and his goals achieved to a higher level in life. The competitive differentiation of the product into the market would make the customer feel apart from the general public. This is the unique benefits of the product which communicate to the customers in terms where he feels inflated. We need to compete with the kind of the brands in the market, and we need to differentiate in terms of the added benefits given to the product, or it is the added advantage increased in terms of relations to the customers. Price is a major identity, but still how we position and portray the brand into the market and how do we relate to the customer's emotions becomes very important. Now here see the brand pyramid, where we have the kind of the basic components of the brand. We have the functional benefits of the brand, then we have the emotional benefits, the personality, the values and the essence. Now the functional benefits of the brand would speak about the product benefits in terms of the utilities given to the customers. This is the total satisfaction in terms of the performance of the product given to the customers. The emotional benefits relate to the association of the product in terms where the desires and the inner perceptions of the customers are satisfied. It is the association of the brand with the person's personality and the social norms in terms of acceptance. Personality is basically a reflection of the brand in terms of a person where education, achievement, liberation and inner feelings related to personal growth become important, and the way the brand portrays this image gets accepted by the customers. Values are basically the kind of the acceptance in terms of the social norms related to religion, culture and society become important, and the essence of brand is basically the self-actualization in terms to crystallize the values associated with the human survival of being achievement oriented and of being ethical in the society. So brand is basically a concept which generally relates to marketing in terms where markets have to be managed. Marketing management, apart from brand, speaks about the growth of the product in society, where innovation, creativity and other strategies to design the product become important. Now when we talk about marketing management, the innovation strategies in terms where the branding tries to give the new products to the society, because the trends are changing, the times are changing and the customers' needs and attitudes also change with the changing political social scenario in terms of the money invested into the market. We have aware customers in terms where education and the impact of media changes the kind of the fashions and the trends. So we need to innovate and grow into the market. The innovation strategies basically relate to the rate of the product development into the society, and it is to build up a kind of a sustainable business model where the technological impact on the product would differentiate the product and give a life that associates with the better performance of the product. We have to have a kind of an impact where the cutting edge of the technology in terms, we need to have a kind of a strong research department where this impact of technology has to be genuinely met out, and we need to have products which are updated in relation to the changes happening into the market. We have three types of products, like we have pioneers, we have followers and the late followers, and according to that we need to relate to the segments of the market and design where the customers invest more in the products which are genuinely designed in a better way and who have updated trends and technological features associated, and people are ready to invest in this kind of category. So this innovation and growth will also give an edge in terms of product differentiation and relating to the branding of the product. The growth strategy relate to the kind of the horizontal integration, the vertical integration, the diversification and the intensification. Now when we talk about these kinds of integration is to capture on the value chain, that is if we are in the kind of the textile industries and we are generally manufacturing the cloth, the forward integration would be to give the designer clothes and to capture the market in terms of the complementary services given to the customers. This is to capture the total product line in order to enhance the total infrastructure required to sell to the customers and to capitalize on the cost aspects. The aggressive strategies is to build on the market, it is to hold on the market and to harvest. The building and the holding of the markets cannot be crystallized unless and until you have a higher sales turnover. The higher sales turnover can only be achieved if we try to integrate the value chain and the distribution channels. And we work on these aspects, it gives a kind of a sustainable edge into the market. Talking about the research in terms of the industry and the market modification relate to the various trends to be studied, not only studied at the micro level but at the macro level. The acquisition of the corporate intelligence services relates to the broad range of topics to be studied when we talk about marketing as a function related to the survival of the organizational growth and sustainability. The macroeconomic factors impacting the product research relate to the economy, the government, the legal, technological, ecological and the socio-cultural factors. Now these factors are important because marketing has to relate and has to sustain the impact of these factors. The economic growth in terms of the recession and in terms of the inflation in the society can impact the product cost and services, and according to the needs of the society, we need to generate the prices of the product which relate to the consumer's purchasing power. The government's basic impact in terms of changing rules and regulation has to be studied in terms where we design the product and services. The legal aspects in terms of the updation, in terms of the changing norms of the society have to be related to the product growth. The technological aspects, the changing technology, the impact of technology makes the product outdated, and so we have to give innovative and designer products to the customers. Like talking about a product like using CDs would be difficult when we have MP3s in the market. So the customers when get used to higher products, it is difficult to sell the outdated products. Ecological is to relate to the environmental values in terms where the quality and the green marketing becomes important. The socio-cultural impacts relate to the cultural values and the kind of the changing norms of the society. The industry research also has to focus on a kind of a market analysis, which is genuinely a kind of analysis done at the detail level. This is the kind of the market definition to which the product is related. It is the market size, that is the market share you want to achieve in the market. The market segmentation basically relates on the kind of the demographic variables of age, gender and education. The industry structure basically is the kind of impact in terms of the various competitors existing into the industry. Then we have the Porter's five force model, where we have the forces in terms where we have the competition from the buyers, competition from the suppliers, the competition from the substitutes and the basic direct competition. So these forces of competition impact the differentiation of services to be needed in the market. We have the supply chain, that is the length of the supply chain would impact the kind of the cost factor related to the product in terms where it reaches to the consumers. We have the competition and the market share in terms where we need to study the competitor's strength and their investment into the market. The competitor's strength and weaknesses will design our strategies to portray and position the product into the market. The market trends in terms of the changing attitudes of the customers and the fashions have to be studied in order to position and design the products. So this is basic impact in terms where market has to integrate all the aspects related to people, product and services. We have shown over here a kind of a model which relates to marketing impacts. Marketing is basically concerned with people. It is people who are designers, it is people who are consumers. So both have to relate in terms to the perceptions, what is needed into the society and who are the providers. So people become important. Here we have the consumers in terms who use the product. Community, we have to build the community in terms where we have to become partners to the community. Then we have the suppliers to whom we relate in terms to buy the products and services. So they are the basic investors. Now when we talk about suppliers, they suppliers the innovative products. When we talk about the customers, they give you the building up of the muscular brands into the society. And when we try to talk about the community, we have the powerful co-markets and systems developed in terms of infrastructure and in terms of society, which is empowered and which is highly standard oriented in terms of the products and services using. A society which is genuinely material oriented and educated uses advanced services and products. The standards of society can be reflected by the brands used by a particular segment of people. Marketing is basically not only a subject, but it is a philosophy associated with human life. According to Peter Drucker, actually marketing is so basic that it is not just enough to have a strong sales force and to entrust marketing to it, but marketing is not only much broader than selling. It is not specialized activity at all. It is the whole business seen from point of view of its final result, that is from the customer's point of view. So marketing is a kind of a philosophy which is based on the customer. And what is customer? Customer is a part of society. So marketing reflects the society. It reflects the total human values in terms of religion, culture, education and the usage pattern of the society. The inner needs and the desires of the people are reflected by the kinds of products and services they use. According to Raphael Waldo Emerson, if you make a better mousetrap, the world will beat a path to your doorstep. This basic line shows that if you have better products and services, the customers will come to you. The basic acceptance will be there and you will be a kind of a person who will be associated with the higher values of acceptance into the society. A kind of a standard can be developed into the market if you have quality products and innovative products related to the latest developments into the society. Now when we talk about the marketing concept in a type of a moving product, this relates to the selling concept, which was a traditional concept taken into the society. The traditional organizations sustain that they have to manufacture the goods and give to the consumers. And through this process, they have to earn process. So when we talk about the supply chain, we have the factory who is manufacturing the existing products. Then we have the selling and the promotion, and then we get the sales, and through the sales volume, we get the profits. So this is the very traditional and the basic concept of marketing. But now see the modernized concept of marketing with changes. We have a market, we need to study the customer wants, we need to study the integrated efforts in terms of the marketing, and we need to attain profits through customer satisfaction. So we have to study the market in the backward terms. You have to do a kind of R&D and research in terms what the analysis of the industry and the market analysis desires, and on the basis of those desires you need to do an investment on the development of the new products and services. So this basic modern marketing concept is not only based on manufacturing and selling, but it is based on the analysis what the consumers want. And if the satisfaction is there and if the relation is there, the profits are going to be generated. So we work on the customers, we try to work on their needs and wants, and then design products according to their basic desires. The marketing concept is shown over here where the customers become important. Now the basically you had senior managers who had to be related to the employees, and the employees used to satisfy the customers. But now here the customers are at the top priority. The customer goes up the pyramid, and the marketing philosophy basically designs the functions and the systems according to the needs of the customers. So this managerial decisions are aimed at the philosophy to maximize the relational aspect and to give a kind of association in terms to build up a persona in relation to the society and to the segment to which you relate. Marketing becomes important because we are in a kind of a business scenario where we need to build awareness related to product. According to Barbara Toffler, when we rationalize a decision we have made or an action we have taken, we often give creditable, although often untrue reasons. It is an intrinsic response driven by a need for psychological self-protection. So it is a kind of a basic identity which you built in terms where you have action-oriented desire to give the products and services to the market. in relation to the concept for the kind of the basic segments of the growth, not only to the human survival, but it is also the growth related to the economic aspects, where the total designing of the infrastructure and the total profits for the economy has to be generated by the businesses we take into the society. We need to study that marketing is not only earning profits, but it is something beyond that. Profits are only a part of sustained growth in terms where we need to survive into the market. But the values and the ethics speak a lot about the kind of the functions and the desirable aspects of the corporations into the society. We have salespeople who directly communicate to the customers, but it is a kind of a communication which is generally a kind of a communication from brand to the customers. And this brand has to speak about the values and the ethics of the organization to the society. According to Ron Willingham, a salesperson's ethics and values contribute more to sales success than to the techniques and the strategies. So it's not only about talking about the marketing strategies in a way where we relate to the investment and the profits and the cost and returns, but it is beyond that we connect to the human values, a kind of a emotional aspect where we try to give sustainability in terms of fair ethics to the businesses. We have life beyond a philosophy, and we have businesses beyond profits, which talk about much larger concept given to the customers in terms to relate to the sensitive human values of being fair, just, fine, and being lovable to people. The mission and the value statements of the organization are reflected by the people who sell products and who give products. The products speak about the promises, the hopes, and the dreams and the desires of many peoples. They relate to the heart of the people and give a kind of a satisfaction to the soul. According to the Minosta Life Insurance Company, we keep our promises. In our all activities, we adhere to the highest standards of ethical conduct. So giving security, giving a kind of a financial background to the person's basic existence and to cover all the kind of the risk is the basic essence and the duty of the marketing organizations and the business organizations to give the polished services to the customers. We have to look to the problems of the people and try to generate the kind of solutions to the people. According to Bob Green, I see them everywhere. This is about salesmen. I see them everywhere. I have come to understand they are among the bravest of us. They face on daily basis what we call dread of the most, the flat, cold rejection. Salesman is that bravest soldier who fights with all the rejections of the customers, who fights with all the no's of the customers and still tries to bring smiles to the customers and gives the products and services which are so valuable to the society. A salesperson is the only soldier who tries to update the economy in terms to generate the GDP and the kind of the economic growth to the society. They are the people who generate the kind of the happiness to the kind of the growth in terms of the business sustainability. Most of them may never have imagined that they would end up doing precisely this. But as long as there is life and as long as there are businesses, there will be salespeople who will connect and collaborate with customers, bring smiles even in spite of their rejections and in spite of their no's. Now let's talk something about the functions of marketing. Marketing functions basically relate to the buying, selling, transporting, storing, grading, financing, risk taking and market information building. So these functions relate in terms where the total business is carried not only from the designing of the product but ultimately taking the product to the customers. And in this total process, we need to transport, we need to store and we need to build up the distribution channels. Distribution channels create relationship with the customers in terms of creating, maintaining and enhancing the kind of the strong value laden relationships. Marketing also relates to the entrepreneurial growth and a kind of a basic professional disciplined approach to enhance the product growth in the market. The orientation towards marketing has to be a kind of a basic evolution from production, selling to the marketing concept. Now here when we talk about the selling concept, the starting point where we have shown you the markets, then profits being built up. But the selling concept where we have the factory and the profits. Now when we talk about the market, here we have the customer needs become important. So customer becomes the basis of the focus and the basic survival of the total business scenario. Marketing management, according to Philip Kotler, carries that process which is planned and executing. So marketing management is the process of planning, executing and conception, pricing, promotion and distribution of ideas, goods and services to create exchanges that satisfy individual and organizational goals. We have the marketing mix in terms built up, where we have the product, price, promotion and place. Now marketing basically serves the society in terms of the functions carried to the customers. Customers are the basis of marketing. Everything associated with the business relates to marketing, because that makes the products connected to the customers. Now, when we talk about products in terms giving values to the society, we have to build brands. According to Kara, when you serve the customer better, there is always a return on your investment. So, better brands build better profits in the market. According to Lewis Carroll, one of the deepest secrets of life is that all really worth is doing what is to do for others. So, brand has to perform and give satisfaction to the others, and then only we can talk about success into the market. According to Tony, being on par in terms of price and quality not only wins you or gets you the game, service wins the game. So customer is important, and to build service sector becomes important. Products and services finally speak about the winning strategy, where everything related to the satisfaction of the customer is the kind of the competitive edge into the market. I hope the students must have understood the basic concept of marketing and the impact of marketing on society. Thank you, students.